My interactions with organizations that have mature data governance programs and those still in the planning or early adoption stage, I find out there are three common drivers for starting such a program. And the last one might be quite important. The first one, regulatory compliance. Now, this is affecting all organizations. When you think about it, at the lowest denominator, all organizations need to comply with their own country's financial regulations. Then there could be region-specific data privacy regulations, some stricter than others, but non-compliance to those can also end up costing large sums of money, as well as bad publicity. For example, according to Deutsche Bank, GDPR fines alone could wipe out 2% from Google's revenue. Then there are industry-specific regulations such as HIPAA, Basel, GLBA, and so forth, which of course can also be country-specific. And lastly, there are those which might not necessarily relate to your own industry, but with the interaction between you and your customers. So similar to GDPR, you might have the CAN-SPAM, HIPAA, PCI DSS, etc. Now, the reason why this tends to score high in the list of data governance drivers is because of the high risks and costs associated with non-compliance. So watch out for this one. Another driver can be a strive for data-driven decision-making. Now, this is an umbrella for a few drivers. So sometimes you might see this stated as, we want to start a business intelligence program, or we want to do data analytics, or we want to start harnessing big data. Other times you might see this as even more business-centric, such as we want to improve the overall efficiency of our organization, or we want to improve customer satisfaction. But the reason why I count all of these under the one driver is because they all go under the idea of knowing what are the best decisions to make based on data. Now, as a side note, when asked, everybody says that this is an important goal to them, but a lot still don't invest in data governance as the necessary foundation to secure success in such program. So why is it only important in theory? Now, the third one is the quality of your data, because it really all boils down to the data quality, and it's why a lot of organizations are pointing towards this as the main driver. Even those which want to start a BI program, ensure regulatory compliance, become more efficient, increase customer satisfaction, and so on, they need to ensure the data is clean, the data is accurate, and in agreement with the data quality dimensions that matter to the business. If you don't have good data quality, then you won't successfully achieve anything I'm mentioning in the first two drivers. The state of quality of your data can make or break everything. And for this, you need a good data governance program. What do you think? What is or was your main driver? Now, check out our accompanying article on lightsondata.com to see what our readers voted on as being their main driver. While you're on the site, feel free to explore, as you can find more informative content such as templates, guides, best practices, articles, and other useful resources to help you with your data governance and data management questions and challenges. So please follow, subscribe, or sign up for the monthly newsletter to never miss out on great content. And don't forget to like and comment. Thank you.